be nearer, my God, to thee, nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee. Though like a wanderer, the sun gone down, darkness be over me, my rest a crown. Still you, my hymns I see, nearer, my God, to thee, nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Now, good morning, everyone. And we say especially now, good morning to the boys from St. Mary's School, 6th class. You're all very welcome, boys. Oh, well, I'm glad to hear that now. And we just keep the boys in our prayers, because the boys, you'll be making your communion, your confirmation in March, won't you? Yeah. So everyone, every morning, will keep you in the prayers that as you're preparing now for your confirmation in March. Now, we continue reading this morning from the story of, from the book of Samuel, the story of Jonathan, David, and Saul. Before now we begin to celebrate Mass, we'll just recall to mind all our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord of mercy, Christ of mercy, Lord have mercy. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Now we will listen to the scripture readings.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. On their way back, as David was returning after killing the Philistine, the women came out to meet King Saul from all the towns of Israel, singing and dancing to the sound of tambourine and lyre and cries of joy. And as they danced, the women sang, "Saul has killed his thousands, and David his tens of thousands." Saul was very angry. The incident was not to his liking. "They have given David the tens of thousands," he said, "but me only the thousands. He has all but the kingship now." And Saul turned a jealous eye on David from that day forward. Saul told Jonathan, his son, and all his servants of his intention to kill David. Now Jonathan, Saul's son, held David in great affection. And so Jonathan warned David, "My father Saul is looking for a way to kill you," he said. "So be on your guard tomorrow morning. Hide away in some secret place." Then I will go and keep my father company in the fields where you are hiding, and will talk to my father about you. I will find out what the situation is and let you know." So Jonathan spoke well of David to Saul, his father. He said, "Let not the king sin against his servant David, for he has not sinned against you, and what he has done has been greatly to your advantage. He took his life in his hands when he killed the Philistine, and the Lord brought about a great victory for all Israel. You saw it yourself and rejoiced. Why then sin against innocent blood in killing David without cause?" Saul was impressed by Jonathan's words and took an oath, "As the Lord lives, I will not kill him." Jonathan called David and told him all these things. Then Jonathan brought him to Saul, and David attended on him as before. The word of the Lord. The response to the psalm is, "In God I trust, I shall not fear." Have mercy on me, God, men crush me. They fight me all day long and oppress me. My foes crush me all the day long, for many fight proudly against me. In God I trust, I shall not fear. You have kept an account of my wanderings. You have kept a record of my tears. Are they not written in your book? Then my foes will be put to flight on the day I call to you. In God I trust, I shall not fear. This I know, that God is on my side. In God, whose word I praise, in the Lord, whose word I praise. In God I trust, I shall not fear. What can mortal man do to me? In God I trust, I shall not fear. I am bound by the vows I have made to you. O God, I will offer you praise, for you rescued my soul from death. You kept my feet from stumbling, that I might walk in the presence of God in the light of the living. In God I trust, I shall not fear. And we rise to acclaim the gospel. Your words are spirit, Lord, and they are life. You have the message of eternal life.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus withdrew with his disciples to the lakeside, and great crowds from Galilee followed him, from Judea, Jerusalem, Idumea, Transjordania, and the region of Tyre and Sidon. Great numbers of all he was doing, who had heard of what he was doing, came to him. And he asked his disciples to have a boat ready for him because of the crowd, to keep him from being crushed. For he had cured so many that all who were afflicted in any way were crowding forward to touch him. And the unclean spirits, whenever they call him, would fall down before him and shout, "You are the Son of God." But he warned them strongly not to make him known. The Gospel of the Lord. Now, we read today from the book of Samuel the story of Saul being very jealous of David and wanting to kill him, and Jonathan bringing about a reconciliation between David and Saul. We will pray for any freedom from anything that is destructive in our lives, jealousy or anger or lack of forgiveness, that we may be reconciled and may use God's good gifts for the benefit of others. Lord, hear us. We pray for young people who are caught up in cycles of violence. We'll pray that they'll have freedom, reconciliation, and healing. Lord, hear us. And we'll pray for all the boys here this morning from St. Mary's School that this time of preparation for their confirmation may be a time when they become aware of God's presence in their lives and God's call to them in their lives. Lord, hear us. And we'll pray for our dead. We'll remember all our deceased relatives and friends. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and my brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished, and we ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Dermot, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the St. Joseph, our blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now we'll stand and pray as our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And we'll offer one another now a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you, and may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now we'll go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.